Looks like you're gonna be hanging here for a while. Just, please, don't touch anything, okay? Yeah, well, you guys didn't leave me much of a choice. But it's all good. Raycast needing some Tony assistance. That's a new level of cool right there. What's he done? More like, what in the history of hacking has he not done? The Packardgate scandal? Him. The NSA leaks of 2020? Him. Guy's a legend. Office? I live here. Everything. Servers, data drives, CPDs, it's my farm. The T-Farm. All for work in the grid. I dish my services, get paid, y'all. Welcome. Job? I'm Tony the Provider. A walk-in, talking cyber-dealing solution. Okay, not much walk-in, but if anyone needs to bust into a game day account, these servers will shake off heat quicker than an icy thing. Need to mine some V-credit to level up on Misty Wizard? My bots dig faster than a rabbit. I got me clients from the East Coast Dam Banners to the West Side Hissy Fits. I made an aim bot for Anti-Strike, okay? Well, a guy's gotta roll with the punches, you know, but I'm not as big a fish as you might think. I mostly stayed home. What can you do? If you get your skills up to me and Decker's level, thank you. You can only hack like any data fortress. Snatch info, disable security systems, plant viruses. And with that weird-ass ability of yours, the freaky no-jack thing, man, we should be talking about what you can't do here. Very briefly, I mean, technically, you should be able to hack into anything or anyone from anywhere. Well, you'll get better with experience. But there is one other way. Get your hands on some special software. Programs that'll make kicking ice even easier. Hey, kicking ice! See what I did there? Hey, Dex, what's up? Oh, me and Decker, we go way back. Who busted him out of C-Space jail? This guy. Who saved his life when he ran into black ice? This guy. Naturally, he came to me now, too. I guess you could call me his Rock. The T-Rock. Of course, not bigging myself up here. Not my style. Nah, with tools like this, you'll be kicking it on the streets. I would. You bet I would. Just, you know, military grade for pizza popping. Bit of an overkill. Hello, it's me, Tony the Provider. Sure I have. Check out my repertoire. But these things cost money, you get me right? I want to help, but I am running a business here. Fine, I'll see what I can do. Jeesh, it's not as if I'm putting my neck on the line just letting you stay here.
How's it going, Blue? Is Niles taking care of everything? Sure, what do you want to know? There are a couple of good packing shops. Hank's ain't far from here, near the Chinese gate. The place doesn't look much, but nobody knows more than him about firepower. Then you've got everyday guns for more fancy pieces. Downtown, near my friend Sam's store. I know a few, but if you go downtown, there's a general store an old friend of mine runs, Sam. Food, drink, meds, first aid kits. You dream it, Sam's got it. All right.
Oh, before you go, I just uploaded you this map of Harbor Prime. Guessing you don't know that part of town so well. Just check it out if you get lost.
Hi there. What can I get you? Please, our menu. Our tofu dishes are the highest rated in all of Taizhou. Rice, dumpling, noodle. What is your pleasure? Please, I suggest you try my traditional Cantonese soy sauce. My aunt's secret method. Not even my mama knows it. Well, it is the number one drink in China, with noodle. Of course. Oh, yes, of course, is my brother Shen. Please tell me you found him. Do you know where he is? I wish I knew. He vanished 2 weeks ago. He said nothing before he left. Only, there was one thing. He met a girl recently. Actually, she's more of a woman. Lily. He changed. I thought nothing of it, but a new style, clothes, hair, always in front of mirror, acting like tough guy in front of customer. A man? A man has a mind. That Lily is Shen's only mind. I saw she was hiding something. I saw she was no good. Ah! But Lily has a friend. Charlene, I think. I heard Lily talk to her. Charlene has job in Chinese Quarter, downtown. I don't know what, but if you can find her, maybe she'll know where to find Shen, or at least Lily. Thank you so much. I light a candle for Shen every night.
world is falling into hell. You know how I will stop the falling? With my secret, my magnus opus. Technology is going to take on a new meaning. Change forever. Unfurl. Fight the power. You might understand. Appearances are shadows, illusions. I used to wear a tie, okay? For Samuel. That's right. Information technology officer. That's what I was. Yesterday. And then things started to happen. They started pulling the knot. Pulling it till I choked. Till I couldn't do my job no more. I was 52. They said I was too old school to work in IT. Pulling the knot. An old guy doesn't get to undo no knots. You got to carry your curses. No one was going to want me when they saw that curse was on my back. I had to cut the freaking tie before it choked me to freaking death. And now is today. The day of demons on all their backs. In the mind, talking, telling you what you're not. Only here on the street they're quiet. Here I can work. Here I'll make tomorrow. But you can help. Yeah, I could use your help. Oh, you help an old man of the street, and when the world kneels, that man will remember you. Antidepressants to shut up the talking ones. Anxiolytics. Venium, whatever. Anything to shut them up. Let me concentrate on my work. Dangerous. No. Get me the pills. Then I'll tell you. This is my circle. I can't step out. I have to check it every morning to make sure it isn't broken. Voices shout from outside. I can hear them. You understand? You understand? Clever girl. Making the right allies. Investing. Clever. I'll wait here. In my circle. It's you. Have you got me some of those pills? Have you? Good. It's important. You might find some in the stores downtown.
Dag! If the sun didn't just come right out. Howdy, sister. What can this old jarhead be doing for you? Smart friend. Yeah, I'm no stranger to firearms. So, you mean business, do you? Well, let me know what catches your eye. How do you, prettiness? What you calling for today? Some say it out loud, yep. Had me a thing for weapons and military gear even before my army days. But I love my antiques too. 20th century memorabilia, all sorts of things. And speaking so, I'm always on the recon for more. So if you empty a basement or find yourself an old trinket or two, bring them in. Just about anything pre-2K I'll offer a fair price for. How do you, prettiness? What you calling for today? More likely than for that other dizzy gun sailor. My suppliers ain't good with pens. Let me take a look now. Booyah! Yes, it is. This here varmint been delayed, lost, or who knows what for 2 months now. Why, thank you, sister. And allow me to express my thanks by giving you 100 credits and a box of shells on the house. What ammo you packing there? Twelve-seven? More than a pretty face, aren't you? Here you go, and thanks again for the deliver it. How do you, prettiness? What you calling for today? Sure enough, it's my name down there. I won't ask where you got it, but if it's what I think it is... Eh? Nothing. Nothing important, couple of magazines, gotta keep on top of the latest trends, you know, and, Big Bazooka's Monthly is just, I'll put them in my special drawer for, research. How do you, prettiness? What you calling for today?
Liking your taste, girl. Cruising for some fun time. A little tramble and relax. How about it? Ain't you the cutest? I'm offering you a moment, girl. No harm in that. Let me lay you down. Come, 80 credits for a dream. You're missing out on some sweet lickety split, girl. You bring that tush of yours back when you change your mind. Hey there, beautiful. Gonna let me charm some of that snake inside again? Get us entwining. Look, I don't know Lily so much as to be calling her a friend, all right? What is it that you want to know? None of your business what exactly. We used to hang out. Don't much anymore. And all. Look, I haven't seen Lily in a while, all right? Why are you looking for them anyway? Look, I don't know nothing about anything, all right? You're talking up trees that ain't your business and ain't mine. Now, if you want to get with me, fine. Any otherwise, leave me be.
A newcomer. Welcome. What can I do for you? Pharmacist is a limiting term. My inventory is more than cough syrups and paracetamol. Besides the official licensed medicines, I offer a range of micro-produced substances. Some call them exotic. A botaner. What may I help you with this time?
Does a bakery sell bread? Yes.
Me some of those pills? Have you? Oh, thank you, lady. Thank you. Come back again later, when they're quiet. I'll introduce you to my advancements.
So you're Dix. Let me have a look at you. I got a hurried message from Decker saying a girl with blue hair was coming in. I'd say there are other descriptors he might have used. Ah, yes. Augmentation. Am I right in thinking you have certain reservations? Trust me. There are no better hands in all of Harbor Prime than these. Look, 95 years of age and steady as a rock. Unnatural. Are vehicles natural? Or should we still ride horses? Is electricity natural? Or should we stick with campfires? And clothes? Should we be running around shivering and showing off our bits? You're fine with a necklet to look the part. Is that really so different to something integrated, functional, and permanent? I mean, how will an augmentation make you any less human if humanity is about progress, and progress is about technology? Technology founded civilization, not the other way around. This here is the next step in the evolution of our species, the natural next step. Or are you worried about being less you? You don't need a philosopher to tell you that you're more than a physical body. Soul, consciousness, destiny, call it what you will. But why would that essence be any worse off if you made your body better? You give it power. Jump higher, run faster, deduce quicker, and kick ass harder. Neuroweave? Well, why didn't he say? We got something of a problem, but I'll come to that if you choose to have one. First, what it is. A neural weave is a neural platform for multiple high-end augmentations. You will become adaptable, scalable, and upgradable. I won't lie, it means you're heading for some drastic changes. Don't worry, the neural weave itself won't affect your appearance. It'll simply affect how your body functions on the inside. But if Decker wants you to install a neural weave, that means more implants to come. This is a spinal attachment that equips your brain to handle stimuli overload from multiple concurrent implants. Multiple. The neural weave is not a drastic change, but the implants that follow will be. I can only guess you'll be coming up against other augmented ones fighting fire with fire. It's the only reason Decker would want you augmented to this level. I can perform the operation for free. I owe Decker that much, but yeah, that's not the problem. The issue is, neuroweaves don't exactly come in cereal boxes. This is a military-grade hardware we're talking about. My usual clients don't need it, so I don't stock it. And here we come to the big problem. I can order a neuroweave, but I daren't. Clearly, Decker hasn't heard. The black market is flooded with defective implants right now. It seems they bring sabotage so that the body rejects them. Nastily. I know one or two suppliers who are still running good lines, but I'm guessing not for long. And with a neuroweave, it's way too risky to install a faulty one. The consequences would be unimaginable. The police are only worried about their own asses. You don't find them putting their neck out over black market shenanigans. These people need to be dealt with outside the system. And the situation is only getting worse. A friend of mine, Dr. Home, owns a drugstore next to Fix's Hope. From what he tells me, folks are barreling in with implant rejection all the time. He wants to put an end to it as much as I. Anyway, the deal is, if you want to get your hands on a safe, legit neuroweave, you should first find out who's sabotaging all the implants. I'd suggest talking to Home. He's bound to know things I don't. But go easy on him. He can be a bit frosty, sure, but he's no bad egg. Hello again, Dex. What can I do for you?
Hi there. Feel free to browse. What you see is what I've got. Did he now? Well, it's a friend who comes down another friend's path, as grandpops used to say. Welcome, welcome. Well, look at you. A mind for good eyes if I ever did see. I do have something nagging at me, you're right. My accountant was supposed to deliver my sales report a week ago, and I'm in some straits wanting it, I can tell you. Maybe a good one if I heard it, but gentleman Mr. Finch has taken it upon himself to go all unreachable on me. Not the first time, granted, but I'm fast near the point of making it his last, I can tell you. He's got a full-time job, granted, but it's the pills I blame, I swear. Ever since his divorce, that man's been up and down more than a yo-yo on a pogo stick. Actually, I'd be happy to throw you a few hundred credits if you'd drop by his apartment and gave that fool a kick. Just a friendly one, of course. Finch lives near Fixer's Hope. You know it, right? Apartment 112. No one home last time I checked, but you look like the lucky sort. If he's out, ask around his neighborhood. He's known around those parts. Oh, how nice of you. Let me take a quick... Oh, Tattoo Dragon! Would you believe I ordered this a good year ago? Where'd you find it? If you keep favors like this coming, you can be as secretive as you please. Thanks again, lady. And here, for your troubles. The least I can do. Howdy. Real pleased to be seeing you. What you got for me?
Welcome. Ah, Thistle Blue, your hair. A symbol of nobility and of pride. A commendable choice, miss. A padishah's choice. It adds spice to your youthful beauty. With a heavy dash of leave me alone. Ooh, and the prickles come out. Fast food, you say? Not here. Here, I humbly strive for the standards of my father Issa's traditional preparation. Please. Let me show off just a little taste of my kofte kebab. Bedava, for free. Don't be shy now.
Yes, yes.
So, do you like it? Ah, she likes it. Here's the menu. Ah, yes, miss. A green thumb I have. A passion for the nature. My little island of color in a graying world. Everything is genetically engineered these days. So sad. It is like we put Mother Nature in the back room and told her she can't cook for the guests. Miss, now you flatter me. I try my best, it is true. I use only natural ingredients, all natural. I grow them myself. At least, I did. My last seeds I used today. You taste them now. A sorry day. The corporations, of course, BioPharmTech and their patents. How can you patent fruits, vegetables, spices? Yes, even spices. They say I cannot grow cumin. That cumin is patented. I must buy it from them. And then I go to their stores and they don't sell the seeds, just the cumin powder. Something about health and hygiene, they tell me. But how can you make real kofte with powders and packets? All the flavor gone. No appreciation of old Adana cooking. Oh, I could never ask you to take such a risk. These people, you prick them with thorns. They shoot you with lead. But of course, if you ever happen to stumble upon a bag or two of cumin seeds, I'd happily take them off your hands. Happily and generously. Not in our offices. Only staff and paper there. So much paper. And our forests fast becoming a memory. But yes, cumin seeds. Try looking around the docks, in the warehouses. All deliveries go through there. But you better hope for the luck, my friend.
Hmm.
A returner. What may I help you with this time?
I do, yes. High levels of stress and anxiety, a delicate situation considering his heart condition, and an A2 state addiction to his meds. He shared with me his problems, personal, professional. One is obliged to listen to Regulus. As to his whereabouts, couldn't say.
An acquaintance of Dr. Niles. I see, yes. I've had a run of panicked customers lately, each showing symptoms of implant rejection. Everything from migraines to hardware burns. I'm equipped to help in most cases, but when a 20-stone roughneck breaks in crying like a child, thrusts his shotgun into your nares and demands your entire stock of morphine, it can be a bit perturbing.
I dare say my head would be all over the counter if they didn't need it to learn which opioids to rob me of. I have my suspicions, yes. Just last week, I was visited by several hooded individuals who promised to execute me if I didn't stop treating those augmented freaks. I asked them how they even knew I had such patience. They were not inclined to answer. I'm waiting for them to realize I've ignored their request. I identified one by his tattoo. Member of the True Bunny Gang. Crusaders of naturalism, they say. But to everyone else, just another brand of thuggery on our streets. They terrorize anyone seen to be sporting hardware. I appreciate those who take a considered approach to ethical cleansing. You have my respect and support. Some simple net running might be all that's needed. Intercept their communications over sea space and learn of their movements. They're not the brightest of individuals, so a moderately skilled hacker should have little problem bypassing their security. You do have hacking experience, don't you? Decker, I know the man. Then I suggest you jack in and learn what you can. Based on that, we'll determine a course of action.